My name is Ngawang Sonam, and I'm the environmental coordinator here at the environmental desk of Tibetan Settlement Office. And actually, this is our Clean Upper Dharamsala program. Actually, it's not an organization. It's a unit undertaken by the Tibetan Settlement Office. And the work that we do over here is like, you know, to look after the waste management in the region of Upper Dharamsala, which is consist of ward number 1, 2, 3 of the municipal corporation, which is also like, you know, this very Upper Dharamsala being a residence of His Holiness the Dalai Lama and the our government in exile, Central Tibetan Administration. Yes, about this unit, actually it was established in 1994. The main reason behind this very, you know, program, Clean Upper Dharamsala program, is that, you know, since His Holiness the Dalai Lama had, you know, came into Dharamsala and become a permanent, you know, residence of the very Upper Dharamsala. So back then in 1960s, 70s and 80s, there were no any kind of like waste issues. Because like most of them were biodegradable and all these things, but mainly because of the plastic manufacturing boomed up in the 80s. So in the very early 90s, there were so many issues of the waste issues, you know. Actually, municipal corporation looks after the very this one, you know, the like, you know, regarding cleaning up the town and everything like that, but it was not up to the mark. So the very local business stakeholders, organizations, institutions, they were like, they thought like, you know, we need to do something, because like this place being a His Holiness the Dalai Lama residence, and also the, you know, also the government in exile is situated over here, the Central Tibetan Administration. So voluntarily in 1994, on the World Environment Day, you know, June 5th, this Clean Upper Dharamsala program was established. And at the moment, we have active members, like we have in a total, we have 12 employees under us. Back then, when we have the sanitation contract with the municipal corporation, we have a total number of 33 employees under us, which is including of the 3 truck drivers and also the green workers and the sweepers. Actually, on a daily basis, we used to clean up the whole Upper Dharamsala, and but like regarding the mass cleanup, we do twice in a month. So on a regular basis, our employees are cleaning up the town. Our truck drivers are, you know, picking up the trash and, you know, dispose it safely at the landfill and everything like that. And also we have a door-to-door service, which is you know, carried out by the green workers. So like they go door-to-door to door-to-door service, they give door-to-door service, and they only collect the driveways. But our sweepers, you know, used to sweep up the whole towns and the streets of the McLeod Ganj, from Baksunak, from Dharamkot, Dal Lake, till the Central Tibetan Administrations. Yes, and yeah, and the challenges that we face is something that actually whenever we have to, you know, shift the garbage containers, something like, like, you know, we need to take the, you know, permission from municipal corporation, the sanitation in charge, from the sanitation in charge. And mainly we face problems, you know, the challenges that we face is like people sometimes illegally dump the waste, you know, in the, you know, places it should not have to dump, you know, like the garbage. So like people sometimes, you know, like, you know, instead of, you know, throwing the garbages in the container, they throw in the drainage, and like also sometimes they throw in the streets and everything like that. So that are the main challenges that we face. Regarding the mass cleanup, actually there is two main objectives behind the mass cleanup. First one is to clean up the very illegal dump sites. So means like, you know, on a daily basis, our employees are cleaning up the streets and everything like that. But sometimes people used to, you know, throw the garbages in the riversides, in the streets, and like that. So where there are accumulation, you know, where there is accumulated of, you know, kind of like garbages in the jungles and everything like that. So what we do over here is like, you know, one objective is that, like, you know, we reduce the illegal dump site. Second thing is regarding the citizenship, you know, citizen engagement that means like, you know, people who wants to volunteer with our kind of like these mass cleanups and all these things. So second point is the citizenship, citizen engagement. So there are the two main kind of like objectives that we carried. So regarding the expectations from the 20th April, you know, mass cleanup, the thing is that first main thing is like we are cleaning up the very illegal dump site, which has been happening for a very long time, which is situated at the below the Haunted Hill Hotel. So that very spot, you know, we had been cleaning up for a long time, but like the people's, you know, behavior or manner, what should I say, manner, you know, once we clean up the whole area, you know, they again, you know, accumulate, you know, the garbage is still accumulate, you know, after 1 week or something like that. So, but this time it's very kind of like special that we are, you know, carrying out this mass cleanup, because like there's one Gujusum, which is on a Jogiwara road, we have placed a garbage container back then. So there, you know, there were so many issues regarding, you know, garbage problems, and also the residents, so many residents are there. So we have shifted that very garbage container at the very Haunted Hill site. So from expectations from this mass cleanup is like, once we clear up this, you know, whole garbages that are accumulated in the below the Haunted Hill, once we clear up this whole area, then next time we, our expectations are that people will, you know, instead of throwing at the, you know, very like, you know, garbages in the, like, you know, open area, they will be throwing the they will be throwing garbage at the very container, which is situated very next to the very illegal dump site. So from regarding this 20th April mass cleanup, our expectations are like, once we clear up this whole garbages, and like next time we are expecting the very local residents to throw their garbages in the container instead of throwing in the very like, you know, jungles and all. You know, like regarding the campaigns and like awareness, what we do is like we go to the schools and give a lecture on how, you know, they can manage their waste from the very, you know, from school level, and also like when they, you know, like, you know, once they are out of school, how they should, you know, conduct this whole like this manners and all these things. So we go schools, you know, Indian schools, Tibetan schools, to give the very lecture on like waste management, not only the waste management, regarding the whole environmental issues like global warming, like, you know, and like how the landfills have to be managed, how sewage treatment plants should be managed, how waste incineration plants used to manage, and all these things like that. And also another thing is that, you know, we, you know, do also like on a street level, on a street level, how we you know, conduct this kind of like awareness and campaigns is like, whenever we have like volunteers and interns from all around the world, say like Denmark, Sweden, on everything. So on a yearly basis, we have a students coming from Denmark, Sweden, and different volunteers. What we do is like, we do a flash mobs in the very streets of McLeod Ganj, with carrying banners and like everything that, you know, so that, you know, very like the residents of the Dharamsala will be getting aware, like, you know, how they should have to manage their ways and everything like that. So we do also on a street level, we do campaigns and flash mobs and everything like that. Yeah, and also, yeah, these are the things that we do. And also whenever we are doing mass cleanup, also at the very same time when we will be doing mass cleanup, we'll be carrying like whole this mic systems and everything, and shouting at the very street level, like, don't throw garbage, you know, put the garbage in the bins, and like instead of throwing in the open areas. My suggestions to the very public of, in you know, Upper Dharamsala, or say Dharamsala, and the residents of the Dharamsala, will be like, you know, instead of throwing their garbages in the open area, they should be throwing the garbages in the bins that are, you know, installed in different locations of the town. So means like, usually what the general public do is like, most of the time at the night time, so when the peoples are like, you know, in their homes and everything like that, they throw the garbage, because like in you know, they only have to walk 100 meters actually. Most of the time people also, the garbage that are installed, garbage bins that are installed, are actually quite near. Some are like 50 meters, you know, from their very residence and everything like that. But mostly the public, what they do is like, you know, when in the night time, when, you know, everyone will be sleeping, they will be, because of the laziness, you know, actually, they don't want to walk, you know, all the way 100 meters or like 50 meters. So when there is no one around the area, they used to throw the garbages. So this is the main suggestions that I want to give to the very residents of the Dharamsala. Like, instead of throwing, you know, garbages in the open area, they should better, you know, because like we have our, you know, also our wet waste truck. Our wet waste truck, what it does is like every early morning from 7:30 to, you know, till 11:30, they go street to street. And the general public actually knows it, like at what specific time will the very waste wet waste truck will be coming near their doorsteps. So instead of throwing the garbages in the open area, better to use, you know, like this, the, you know, like facilities that we are providing, like trucks and like garbage bins and everything like that. Also, like whenever our green workers are coming door to door to collect your dry waste, instead of from the very house level, you can segregate. You have to separate the very wet waste and the the very dry waste. The dry waste, you can hand them to the very our green workers, and wet waste, the very wet waste, they can throw in the garbage bin. And also, I would like to recommend, like, you know, if you have a food waste, like biodegradable waste, you can do also composting, you know, composting. And it's like some people say, like, they don't have a specific, like, you know, place to do composting, but there are so many ways to do composting, right? Some people can do backyard composting. Some, you can also do composting in your buckets, like, you know. So these are the suggestions that I want to give. And yeah.